For the topic, we consider the equate two-phase attraction. Previous topic, we talk about the organic solvent attraction. That means we use the organic chemical at the solvent. That sometimes the organic chemical will be hazardous to the biomolecule like protein, like antibiotic, like amino acid. Sometimes it will be the nature based on the chemical. Okay, for this case, we will utilize the two-phase attraction. That means we have two solvents. Both solvents dissolve in water. That's right. Both solvents dissolve in water. We have two-phase, but this two-phase include water. What? Previously, we have the aqueous system and the solvent only. That's right. But sometimes the solvent will be denature the biomolecule. And also the same operation. Both phase have to be immiscible liquid. Immiscible means these two phase did not dissolve together. That's right, did not dissolve together. And then we add the solute or the the solution that include the solute into these two phase. That's right, into these two phase. And then the solute will transfer to the phase that the prefer. That's right, the phase that they prefer. For this case, we apply for the equate two phase. For the enzyme protein separation of virus cell or cell organelle, that's right. The commonly used for the bioprocess. Commonly used for the bioprocess. And also for this case, we show you the diagram for the equate two-phase system. Like for this, we have the dextran and water system and polyethylene glycol and water system. This also in water. This also in water. That's right. And the bottom line is the equilibrium. The equilibrium. That's right. The equilibrium. And also for this case, the zone below the equilibrium line, we find it the one phase. This is somewhere this system dissolve together. And above this line, we find the two phase after the separation. That's right. After the separation. And if you would like to know the composition at the top phase or the bottom phase, this is the point at the top phase. This is the point at the bottom phase. So we draw the tie line. This tie line, if you know the mixing point, is the concentration at the start point. That's right. If we mix, for example, we mix at about 10%, 12% of dextran and about 7% of polyethylene glycol. And you can calculate the top and bottom composition. That's right. This is the top composition, this is the bottom composition. And it could be at the technique. And also you can use the liver arm rule like this. The distance from MB divided the distance from MA equal to V top divided by V bottom. V mean the volume of the top divided by the volume of the bottom. Example. That you can use the ruler to measure the distance from M to A, the distance from M to B. You can approximate the ratio of the volume by the ratio of the distance from A, M, and MB, for example. This technique. Okay. This is show you the diagram of the equilibrium data. That's right. This table shows you the example of the equate two-phase system. Find some the polyethylene glycol is for water, that's right. And this also water, we call it aqueous two-phase. We can use two, the polyethylene glycol and dextran, use to dissolve and remove some the protein, some biomolecule, or polyethylene glycol, polypropylene glycol, glycol or methylene cellulose, something like that. Okay, this I talked to you already from the curve. That's right. For example, if we would like to separate protein, we use this separate protein from the polyethylene glycol is phase. From in the system using 10% polyethylene glycol and 15% dextran, we use the polyethylene glycol and dextran system. That's right, to separate that protein. And or we use the 15% of polyethylene glycol and 15% of potassium phosphate. That's right. And the value of K our protein is like from 0.1 to 10, but as higher K value, higher separation of the protein. For this case, the equator phase, that's right, or K value, this depends on the biopolymer property, like size of the biopolymer, protein, polysaccharide, sugar. This is also biopolymer. It depends on the size, molecule, the charge, the surface, hydrophobicity, hydrophilicity, left water or not left water, something like this. Composition, that's right, the concentration, or the affinity ligand or property of the phase, chi or the type, the native concentration, that's right, something like that, or the salt included in the system, that's right, included in the system. Okay, for this case, if the lower polyethylene glycol increase the dextran molecular weight, tend to increase the K. That means if you use the low polyethylene glycol, low molecular weight of polyethylene glycol, and high molecular weight of the dextran, okay, will be increased the partition coefficient. That's right, partition coefficient. Also, high molecular weight protein, like catalase, compared to cytochrome, like this. We can use this technique to separate the protein with high molecular weight. Or cytochrome, that's right, or something like this. Okay, the larger the difference between polyethylene glycol concentration in the two phase, the concentration of the equator two phase also affect partition coefficient. That's right, the first step, it depends on the type of polymer. The second one, it depends on the difference between the concentration. That's right, the concentration also affect the partition coefficient. That's right. The partial hydrolysis of dextran and polyethylene glycol also increase the partition coefficient of KD. That's right, KD. This, for example, the K value of formulate increased by a factor of 6 when polyethylene glycol formulate and polyethylene glycol 4,000. Sometimes we mix polyethylene glycol with different molecular. This is type of polymer. That's right. Polyethylene glycol will have more than one type. It maybe depend on the size of the polymer. It maybe if we mix PEG 400 with PEG 500, sometimes we increase the K value, increase the affinity for the extraction. Right. And also this it show you the factor of K. That's right. K will increase for protein like molecular weight of protein. The molecular protein increase, K value decrease. And also this is some type of the protein, that's like insulin, beta galactosidase, that's like this is for the overalbumin, something like this. You can see that the molecular weight or the size of protein also affect the K value. And this is the effect of salt or pH, effect of salt or pH also affect the K value. If we look at this line, this three line, that's right, decrease. The chloride salt, that's right. This is for high of pH 6,000 to 500. The open symbol is the chloride salt, that's right. When you increase the pH, when the system of chloride salt, K will decrease. That's right, K will decrease, and also sometimes slightly increase for the sulfate, that's right, sulfate, potassium, sodium, that's right, for this case. When you increase the pH in the system of sulfate or sodium, then sometimes K value is slightly constant, that's right, slightly constant, but for the sodium chloride, that's right, the K value is decreased. This is depend on salt and depend on pH. That's right, depend on salt and depend on pH. Okay, it's quite complex when you separate or purify the biomolecule, the biological product. It depends on the size of biomolecule. It depends on the salt, depend on the pH, and also depend on temperature and pressure. That's right, this is effect of temperature. The phase separation occurs when the polymer at lower molecular weight for lower temperature. That's why for PEG dextrane water system, why the opposite is true for PEG salt water system. That's right. If we use the PEG dextrane water, it's good for lower temperature. But for PEG salt water, it's good for high temperature. That's right. But usually lower temperature will increase the partition coefficient. That's right. That increase the attraction efficiency. Because this is increase the high and low molecular weight of protein. That's right. High and low molecular weight of protein. Okay, the next step we will talk about the idea of the aqueous to phase attraction. So previously we talked about the introduction about the aqueous to phase system. It depends on the type of polymer, the type of biopolymer, the type of salt, the type of solvent that you use for the aqueous to phase. This also depends on the pH, depends on the salt, depends on the temperature. But now we quantify the ideal state if you would like to separate. Okay, after you mix, well, the first step we call it the mixer. That's right. We have two phase. What phase is water included? That's right. Then mix together. This is Li1, CaI1. This is for the phase one and phase two. We call phase one and phase two. Mix together and then settle. For the settle, is the phase is separate in upper phase and lower phase. Upper phase and lower phase. The concentration in the upper phase we call CO1, that's right. And lower phase is CO2, because it's outlet one, outlet two. One is the upper phase, two is the lower phase. L is the amount of solution, that's right. One and two. Okay, for ideal state, CO1 and CO2 at the outlet is equilibrium, that's right. It should be the equilibrium concentration. For that case. And also you can calculate the partition coefficient is defined at K equal to CAU divided by CAL. CAU means the equilibrium concentration of component A at upper phase. That's right, at upper phase. CAL, this should be CAL. CAL is the equilibrium concentration of A in the lower phase. Okay, this is the upper phase, it's lower phase. Is K greater than one? K greater than one, that means the solute prefer to the upper phase. If K less than one, the solute it prefer to the lower phase. That's right, that's mean. If we have upper and lower, K greater than one, the solute prefer to the upper phase. If K less than one, the solute prefer to the lower phase. That means if K less than one, so you transfer from the upper to lower phase. If K greater than one, so you transfer from the lower phase to the upper phase. That's only the partition coefficient. And commonly for a single state attraction, like enzyme, the K should be greater than three, normal operation. If you would like to separate enzyme, we need at least three for the K value. And also the K value, it depends on the size of molecule, the charge of the molecule after dissolved in water, the hydrophobicity, that's right. This is like water or like water, something like that. Okay, and also if we would like to calculate the yield, that's right. The yield mean the percent of the solute that you can separate from the feed system, that's right. More the yield is amount of the based on yield of the upper phase. Concentration of the upper phase multiplied by the volume upper phase. You get this amount of the solute at the upper phase. Divide as V0 and CA0. V0 and CA0 means the initial amount of solute. That's right. Initial amount of solute before mix together. That means the solute recover solute recover divided by the initial solute. That's right. Initial solute is the yield. That's right. The yield. And then you multiply by 100, you get percent yield. okay, you can express V0 and TA0. From the mass balance, V0 and TA0 equal to V upper, TA upper, V lower, TA lower. That's right. V lower, TA lower. Because we have the attractor. This is V0. It is TA0. V0 is volume multiplied by mass or mole per volume. You get mole or mass of CO equal to, this is the VUCAU, that's right. VLCAL, lower and upper. For the mass balance with the steady-state system, input equal to output, no generation, no consumption, we get V0, CA0 equal to VUCAU plus VLCAL, that's right. This is the definition of the yield for the upper phase. If we calculate the yield for the upper phase, that means the solute prefer to the upper phase. And also you can calculate it on the yield of lower phase. That's right. It's the same definition, the same technique to define VLCAL divided by V0, CA0. You get this. Okay, for this case, we can rewrite because for this case, you have to know the concentration at lower and upper. But sometimes you can convert this to the volume and K value only, that's right, from the complex to be the compact, that's right, or the easier to use. Okay, for this case, if you multiply or divide both sides, top and bottom by CAL, CAU, that's right. You divide this term by CAU, 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 something like this, CAU, CAU. For this case, it's K, that's right. CAU cancel, it's K. And then you get the term of YU equal to, YU equal to VU divided by VU multiply plus V1, VL over K. You only use the information of volume and K value. That's like, it's the same as I show you the diagram. You can calculate V top, V bottom, if you know K value. And also the same, if you divide both sides by CAL, 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 and then you can express this in terms of K and V. That's like, K and V for this. This is YU, this is YL. And another term, the concentration factor, delta C equal to CAL over CA0 or CAU over CA0. That's like for lower phase and upper phase. For this case, for example, we have extraction of two phase to recover alpha amylase from the solution. We use two phase, polyethylene glycol and dextrin mixture. That's like polyethylene glycol with water, dextran also with water, because it's aqueous two phase. That's right, aqueous two phase. After mixture with the enzyme, that's right, the partition coefficient is 4.2. This means the enzyme prefer to the top phase or the top phase. That's right. Okay, maximum possible enzyme recovery. Maximum enzyme recovery. That's right. If we use the volume ratio of VU per VL equal to 5 and VU per VL equal to 0.5 and then calculate the maximum enzyme recovery, that's right, maximum enzyme recovery. Okay, from the information we YU, that's right, YU or YAU, you can multiply, you can divide term of YU by this, VU, that's right, VU, VU. Okay. Because we know only the ratio of VU over VL. Okay, you divide VL, not VU, okay, sorry. Okay, you divide this by VL, by VL, this cancel, and VL, because you know VU over VL from the following statement. you get this relationship. VU over VL divided by VU over VL part 1 over K. Okay, for the first question, we know VU over VL is equal 5. You substitute this, substitute this, substitute K. You get 0.95. It's 95% recovery. If you use the higher volume in the upper phase, that's right. Okay, if you use the lower volume of the upper phase, it's VU over VL 0.5. You substitute, you get about 0.68 or 68% recovery. What does it mean? For this case, if you increase the volume of the upper phase, you also increase the percent recovery. If you decrease the volume of the upper phase, you decrease the percent recovery. Why? For this case, because K is greater than 1. That's right. K is greater than 1. For K is greater than, you have to increase the volume of upper phase to increase the attraction efficiency. In the opposite, if K is less than 1, for this case, I think you need to increase the volume of lower phase. That's right, because the K less than 1, the product prefer to the bottom phase, not upper phase. Okay, the time is over. Okay. But today I